Hello everyone, welcome back. Now we're going to take a look at the demolition plans. So, just like before, once again we have the basement first and second floors. Let's zoom in on the top. Let's look at the second floor and work our way down. So, one of the nuanced things about demolition plans is that there's going to be existing items to remain, and then there's going to be existing items to be demolished. So, how do we code those two different things? How do we distinguish if something is going to get demolished or something is going to remain? Well, very clearly, if you look at this plan, you'll see that there are two wall types being graphically represented. We have these solid gray walls all throughout the building, and these are going to be the existing to remain. Then we have these dashed lines. So there's casework in the bedrooms, there's toilets, there's sinks, there's various fixtures in the bathrooms that are getting demolished. There's a handrail for the stair here that's going to get demolished. We have a couple doors that are getting removed. So very clearly, those are the items that are getting removed. Now, this might not be the case in every single project that you work on. This is just kind of how this firm chooses to graphically represent these items. But just know that for this project, that's going to be the graphic nomenclature. Now, with each item that's getting demolished and removed, there is a keynote. That's what these little bubbled numbers are, letters and numbers. So you see in each room where we have casework that's getting removed, we have a D22, we have a D9. In the bathrooms, we have D15s, D16s. So let's go ahead and take a look at a few of those. So let's look at a D15. So this is your keynote legend. It may be on the same sheet or it may be elsewhere, but it's probably best if it's on the same sheet so that you can easily reference things. So D15 says remove existing toilet accessories, including but not limited to toilet, paper towel, and toilet tissue dispensers, soap dispensers, mirrors, grab bars, and hand dryers, curtain rods and curtains, shower benches. That's a mouthful. It's a lot of scope. But it's necessary to call out all of these different items because we have to. When dealing with these existing building projects, what's important to note is that we really need to be making sure we capture as much scope as possible because time is money. When people are out in the field, you want to minimize the amount of time that people are standing around, not knowing what to do. They have to ask a question which has to go upstream to their boss, to their boss's boss, then to the architect, have to issue an RFI. It takes a long time. So if we can be overly descriptive with our text scope, we're better off. So it may seem like overkill to be saying that remove the grab bars and the curtain rods and the curtains and the shower. No, get rid of everything. Because also, when the contractor's pricing out the job, they factor all this stuff into consideration. It might not even cost them that much extra time or money, but it's just the fact that they want to know all of the scope that is going to occur. So that was the D15. Let's take a look at the D9 and the D22. That's for some of the casework in the bedrooms. So D9 says remove portion of existing interior framed wall assembly as indicated. Okay, so if we shaft back over here, the D9 is pointing to these little wing walls. Pretty simple, straightforward comment. D22, remove existing built-in casework, including base cabinets, standards, wall cabinets, blocking, trim, countertops, sink, fixtures, piping, and all associated materials in their entirety. Get rid of everything. Again, this is a note that can be applied to a few different things. So it's like, we don't have to have like five different notes if we're saying remove countertop, remove casework, remove cabinets. Like, we're just going to cover all that in this one note, and we're going to say get rid of all this stuff, and we're going to point to it. Then there's these D19 guys that are floating out here in space. Let's take a look at those. Remove existing light fixtures and leave all wiring and existing conduits to reuse, typo, the same locations to receive new fixtures. Terminate, abandon, or obsolete Ooh, another typo. Sorry, guys. Or otherwise unused conduits and wiring back to panels. Coordinate exact location as per electrical drawings. So that's why this isn't really pointing to anything specific, because in the plan, it's just saying that remove the existing light fixtures and all that stuff up there. So since it's just kind of, the keynote is just kind of floating in the middle of space, it doesn't really have to point to anything. We're getting the point across pretty straightforward. So that's the basic idea of keynotes, demolition keynotes, and how they work. So as you can see, if we just pan to the rest of the building, it looks like we're removing the storefront here at the front of the building. We're removing this handrail at the stairs. If I scroll down, it's probably a lot of the same scope that's happening on the floors below, although the layout is slightly different. Getting rid of a lot of doors, getting rid of what is this, concrete retaining wall and railings. Yeah. Okay, let's zoom in on these windows real quick. I remember there was some work we had to do to the facade and the windows. D4 and D35. Let's take a look at these guys. So D35, excavate existing grade and saw cut existing retaining foundation wall to receive new opening for window well and PTAC unit. So what we were doing, this project, the existing building did not have AC, did not have central air. It had short ceiling heights, so the best way that we could get a mechanical unit in this building was to provide PTAC units for each office / bedroom. So this is basically saying, this note is kind of specific to the ground floor or to the basement floor, because it is talking about the grade. It's talking about like excavation and saw cutting the existing portion of the wall to put the new PTAC unit into the wall. PTAC unit is like one of those like window units, but it's not in the window, it's in the wall, because it's better. And then I wonder if there's an elevation for that. I bet you there is. Oh yeah, we have a section. Yeah, so, no, that's not it. Here we go. So here's the elevation. Listen, this was not a sexy project. It just had to get done. We need college kids to have their central air. So here you can see these are the new PTAC units under the windows. See the little louvers over there? So that's shown on the elevation right there. And then we have our wall section, which shows the new unit. See, so in each floor, we're showing the new PTAC unit in the existing wall. Again, this is a solid white element that's overlaid over an existing solid gray element, showing that this is new work over an existing element. And then if we follow this call out, it's going to take us right here. So this basically just shows a really close-up version of the an enlarged detail of the PTAC unit as it sits in the wall. It shows the steel supporting lintels to support the brick above. It shows a conduit at the floor and the base that's going to cover the conduit so you don't see it. It's going to show the sill flashing. Can't talk today. So you get the idea, right? Okay, I just wanted to kind of... I just want to show like what the finished product was eventually going to be, just so that you can kind of visualize it a little bit better. Now let's get back to the demo plans. So that's the big scope that's happening with the windows. And yeah, it looks like there's some stuff going on in the hallway down here. Let's look at these guys, D45, D11, D19. Actually, wait, no, I didn't end up looking at D4. What was D4? D4 for those windows. Saw cut and remove portion of existing masonry opening walls below windows to create opening for new PTAC units. Provide lintels and supports as indicated. So that's basically referencing that detail that we were just looking at, where you're just going to cut a hole under the window and put the new PTAC unit in. Okay. So we're not going to go, I don't think it's necessary to cover every single keynote item. I do want to just quickly look at this elevation though. This is kind of this little bay on the building that has glass block. So we're going to be removing a portion of this glass block and filling it with brick. I forget why. I think we had like, we were like doing something to the stair and we needed that wall space to mount a landing or a stringer or something. But let's just quickly look at this D46 keynote. So if I go over to D46, remove existing glass block fenestration as indicated, provide toothed in brick infill to match existing. So we're basically saying, get rid of this glass block. We're going to do brick infill and try to make the joint lines match up to the existing. So it doesn't look like infill. It always does. It's never going to look great. But, you know, this is just one of those things. Again, it had to be done. This isn't supposed to be an award-winning project. We have to just get this work done. So you can also have demolition elevations. Demo drawings aren't solely for a floor plan or, you know, a horizontal surface. It could also be for the vertical plane. We can also show demolition items for vertical surfaces and elevations. All right, so that's it. That's it with the demo plans. I think that's pretty straightforward. Now we're going to move on to the floor plans.